This is Ninjala. This is a free-to-play game on the Nintendo Switch. It is a very simplistic sort of brawler game that the visuals sort of remind me of the Splatoon series, whereas the gameplay reminds me of the stupid ARMS game. That's right, I wasn't a fan of ARMS. Sorry. So anyways, in this game, there are basically two maps you play and two modes you can play within. You unlock the ladder team battle after having completed a number of matches and leveling up, and that opens things up for ranked or casual play. I didn't really find this to be too thrilling to jump into ranked matches, so I mostly just played casual games. Now, there is a paid component to this. There is a single player story that you can kind of buy. It's fairly cheap, and it's like a chapter. It's like a comic book style content that you can play offline, whereas this mode obviously is an online competitive. They call it a battle royale, but it really isn't. So with that, there are a number of other things you can do. You can unlock basically costumes and design your character. I will say that the character customization in this is absolutely splendid. They did a great job on that. You really can customize your character in just such a wide range of ways, from colors to designs. And then there's tons of different weapons. They do have a battle pass, which is, I guess, just sort of expected of any free-to-play game with a sense of progression, I suppose, these days. And from there, that is the gist of the game. It's fairly simplistic. It's down to basics. But I mean, if you like this style of melee-based combat, you'll probably enjoy the experience. So when you're playing, we're going to focus on generally the battle royale first, and then talk a little bit about the team battles. So the gist of it is 8 players are in an arena. It's a free-for-all. If you're in battles, it's 4v4, which makes complete sense. And then there's self-hosted battles you can do too if you want, whatever. So with that, you're in this arena, you're trying to collect points and kind of build your stuff up so that you can get sort of ultimates kind of going. You're just going around doing these, I guess you could say, almost rock, paper, scissor-esque little conflicts with others or getting the drop on them. Sometimes you just randomly go flying and die. It's honestly quite a bit of nonsense to me a lot of the time. I didn't do too bad for a lot of matches. I was getting some first place, second place, third place and stuff. But it just really looks like random nonsense where I just kind of move the stick around and then get behind them. And it was just like complete chance whether or not you actually get in there and hit them. Sometimes you'd have neat abilities where you'd do like a big tornado or something like that, or a big burst. And there's a lot of like gum-oriented content in this too, like literal gum, like chewing gum. And that has a way to kind of play into what is going on too. And then there's like someone had a weird donut, a basketball net. There's just a lot of strange stuff going on. And there's all these like extras you can grab in the arenas. I would have liked more like maps to play on. I know it is a free-to-play game, but it's just so simplistic. It's literally a square. The other city map, which we'll show in just a minute or so, it's a lot more complex, a lot better of a map design, well, at least in getting you moving places. Whereas this is just so simple, but it's really just like a couple maps, and that's all there is to it. Matches are incredibly quick and fast-paced, to the point that I actually had to record a couple and snip them up in order to make this video, because usually I like to do a live show and chat, but that really just didn't work for this type of game because the lobbies are, that's another thing, that lobbies are a little awkward and a little glitchy. It's hard to get out of them once you get like kind of stuck in some of them, to the point that I even had to like reset the game in order to actually switch up the lobby info and everything. It was a little tiring. Sometimes it worked, but sometimes it just was not. And then there's lots of little tiny bugs like server issues, match disconnects when you're trying to get into stuff, little things like that. I mean, it's not the worst. The worst part is that it literally takes longer to get into matches than it does to actually play the matches. You have to like wait for everybody to sync up, and then you go to like this pre-lobby dojo thing in order to train, I guess, and then you play the games and they're like a few minutes long and you're on your way. It's just not really that great. I really don't find this to be that interesting. I think it's kind of stupid. I give high praise to the character customization. I think the visuals look really cool. I like the style that it's in. It just feels very contained and very basic of just like a brawling game. There's no real sense of like intense competitive skill. You can be decent just by coming in here and just being like, okay, I just move the stick around and then I tap and hit and then I get lucky and I take folks out in this. That's really all there is to it. It's nothing too complex. It's nothing too interesting. It does have a fun, charming, lovely look to it, and I think that fits well on the Switch. And you know, if you like this sort of game, from what you're seeing, you know, I'm not gonna nag you too much on it. I just personally think it's kind of stupid, but I know a lot of people might really enjoy this type of thing, and I'm just trying to give my opinion on that and give you an idea what it's like. I mean, it's got some flashy visuals to it, some neat abilities. It runs relatively smoothly. It does have some performance hiccups throughout, but I mean, it's not too bad of a time playing through here. And there just really isn't a whole lot to it. There's a lot of depth in like customizing your character, which is greatly appreciated. I know a lot of people really liked, you know, the character customization, myself included, for games. Weird, funky colors, weird designs, you get different tools and things as you're leveling, and that felt fair. I did like that the microtransactions aren't really pushed too much. It is good that there is like a single player component that you can buy. I think that's a fair ask of people in regards to a free game, but I was just hoping for more content. There's a lot of free-to-play offerings out there these days, and this just isn't something that, even if I liked it, would really hold my attention for a long time. Like, the main map in the game, because this one was actually really hard to get into, this, I guess you could say, I don't know if it's New York, but, you know, city area, high-density downtown area. It was kind of hard to get into a match for it. I had troubles. Like, it kept disconnecting. It kept, like, lobbies failing because I guess there wasn't enough players. And the other one's just, like, a simple, basic square. I guess you're like, oh, well, you need one good map. That's all you need in a game. I beg to differ. I like variety. I like something that's a little bit unique. And I think this one plays a lot more to the strengths of the fact that this is a game where we're playing as, I guess you could say, bubblegum-type ninjas. And you know, this actually uses the verticality elements of the game a lot more, whereas the other one kind of lazily has like a box in the middle section that you can run up the walls, but nobody does. They're just hitting each other mindlessly. It's kind of mindless nonsense, quite honestly, the whole game itself. But this one actually does play to the idea of, again, verticality, jumping along the rooftops, running off the wall, which is super easy, hopping along areas, and then it's also got some flat spaces where the conflict happens. I'm just saying that this one plays to the strengths of the concept of the gameplay a lot more than I think the base map does. And I think it was a mistake to make this map right here something that's like basically the baseline for the experience. It's what you really first get into, and it's what you'll probably play a lot of. Like, it looks cool, it's got flashy visuals, there's lots of shapes and everything and everywhere. But if you break it down, it's literally just a square with a plus sign elevated in the middle. That's it. Even has all these stations that you go hit to build up points on the outside of the square, so you're not even most of the time focusing everyone into, like, flow-wise, you know, game flow-wise, into the middle. There's a lot of people that just sit on the outside and hit stuff, and they're not even getting involved in the conflict. It's just, I don't know. I felt they could have done more with the modes, too. Maybe they could have done 2v2v2v2, could have been really cool. You know, 4v4 and the free-for-all does make the most sense. And I think they maybe even needed just a quick play. It's weird that you can so strategically pick what you want to do, just for the fact that there isn't much to pick from. They give you, like, the in-depth choices of matchmaking of, like, say, a Call of Duty title, but with the fact that there's two modes, two, you know, things, casual, ranked, and then two maps. It's just, there's just not enough to really justify it. It should just be quick matches to jump in, ranked or casual. And then it just randomly picks between the two maps. It just kind of leads to a lot of extra issues that I think could have been, like, you know, not really necessary or really didn't have to happen in this one. That aside, it's, I think for some people, okay, I really didn't care for this one. I didn't really like it that much. Like, it's got cool, flashy visuals that might look really neat and enticing when you're watching it, But when you're playing it, it just seems nonsensical. Even when I was doing well, I was kind of like, why am I doing well? How am I doing well? And I think that's a problem when you're playing a game and you're like, oh, I finished first. I mean, I didn't do that every time. Sometimes I finished dead last, and I was like, whoa, I don't even know what's going on. But when I was finishing first, I wasn't getting any sense of, like, I guess you could say accomplishment over the fact that I was like, yeah, I'm first place. But you don't know why you're first place, if that makes sense. Or I didn't get that sense of, you know, this is why I'm winning this match. This is why I'm doing so good. Or I can understand my actions that led me to get to that point where I'm doing well. I kind of just ran in and started hitting people that had the lowest health, throwing off a tornado ability sometimes or a dash to hit someone. Then I'd randomly shake my controller Joy-Con around in a circle and then randomly click attack, and then I would hit somebody, and that was kind of the gist of it. I should have mentioned this earlier, but there are a number of ways to play too in terms of the control scheme. They have the gyro motion. They have automatically controlled camera, or they have free camera. I picked free camera because I like to have full control when I play games, and I'm not a fan of gyro in most titles. I just don't care for it. Sorry. And with that, you can also lock on. I think you've maybe been seeing that as I've been playing, but you can kind of lock on to characters. You just got to be careful how you're using it, because sometimes it's a bit annoying with how it draws you away from the attention of what you're actually wanting to focus on. So it's got some neat visuals, it's free, it's just basic, I can't see it lasting too long, I can't see the interest being there, but who knows on the Switch, it kind of fits into the lineup, right, I guess, I don't know. We'll have to see if their monetization methods actually keep this one afloat. I thought the campaign aspect was interesting, I didn't get to play it, you know, because I'm not paying for it, because I don't really like this game that much, but yeah, it's a neat thing to do, and that is Ninjala.